Hey everybody, what's up? This is Emilio with Quick Property Solutions. Today we are in Detroit. The zip code is 48206. And today this is going to be a different video. We're not going to be talking about real estate investing in this video. I'm actually visiting a friend of mine. He purchased his house. It's a brick duplex. He's a musician, and not sure if you knew this, but before I got into real estate, I was a musician. I played several venues and several bands in the Detroit area. That's why I love Detroit so much as well. It's one of the, I got a lot of history here. But anyways, he purchased his house and he is using this house as, you know, as a place for artists to come together, musicians, artists collaborate together. And it's kind of like his passion project. And so what I wanted to do is shoot this video to just show you some of the projects that's happening in Detroit, the people that are pouring, you know, their sweat, blood, and tears into these properties, not just for investment purposes, but to create like a, you know, it's for a bigger reason. So I hope you guys enjoy the video. And again, this is Emilio. If you like the video, comment, subscribe to the channel, like the video. I'm gonna have links to Greater Alexander's website and all of his information below in the description. So I'm going to start off by going inside and saying hello. All right, before I get inside the house, let me show you the house. This is the house right here. Let me show you the street. This is on Hogarth. And as far as like how long he's owned the property, improvements he's made to the property, I gotta talk to him and let him tell you about that stuff. But all of these duplexes here, these are all vacant across the street. This duplex was vacant, but you know what I see right there? Oh, one of the telltale signs. Somebody must have bought this because there is a dumpster out here. So hopefully somebody's gonna be fixing up this, cleaning it out. All right, everybody. I'm standing here in front of the Greater Impact House. I'm here with Alexander, Greater Alexander.
Yeah.
And, you know, I just wanted to give him an introduction of the house. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip the camera around and we're just going to, he'll give you an introduction of the house and then we'll actually go inside the house so you can kind of see inside. And then hopefully you guys can show some support and love to this artist. And also kind of like a, you know, visionary bringing art and creativity back to the city, doing it super independent, and I love it. So yeah. There you go. One second, let me flip this around.
So yeah, this I purchased this property in 2018 from Wayne County Auction, and it was pretty much, there was a lot of really great stuff in the house because the person that guarded it, Noak, was just really receptive to what I was attempting to do, and so he let me actually go into the house before I ended up bidding on it. And yeah, the roof was really damaged. And as you can see, the porch is kind of the next go-to investment. We're gonna try to, we really would like to like bring the community in a little bit more with how desolate it is over here. So we're gonna be looking for funding for getting the porch redone and just kind of make an outdoor space, outdoor concert kind of little area, as well as the second floor, which would also be just a great addition to overlook the city and be inspired in the morning. And but there's also a, you can go online and see if somebody wanted to take initiative to look at the whole house themselves. You can go to greaterimpacthouse.com/dollhouse, and there's a version of the whole house that you can walk through in 3D.
That's cool.
This guy named Handbuilt Detroit, Nathan, he ended up walking through with a Matterport.
Yeah, those things are awesome. Matterports are so cool.
There's this grand piano is from over 100 years old. It's a Bose, and it came from a woman that had played it for 80 years. She got it on her 13th birthday.
Wow.
And couldn't play it anymore. And then it was put up, and they basically, it's a church that donated it. So yeah, I'm very thankful to have this, and it's actually in pretty pristine condition.
Yeah.
A lot of this, obviously, we're going to do a lot of shifting around, but right now I have an old exhibition that's happening in the house, and if you go to supportgreater.com/letloveIn, you'll see You'll be able to walk through the exhibition yourself if you're in the Detroit area. So this is kind of like where we envision kind of the studio being. And each of the spaces is going to be for day space residency. So artists can come in and really kind of, it doesn't matter if the medium's music or art, but the basic intention is to create without the use of drugs or alcohol or smoking or vaping, and come in with other artists with that intention in mind. But basically leaving your addictions or your vices or things that you gamble in life with at the door and say like, all right, I'm going to come with a career-driven intention through my art and create that way. I really would like the intention to be more so associated towards like out of state, out of country artists.
Oh yeah, like have a place to kind of, yeah.
And then see a closer look at Detroit. A lot of people don't realize that even just in the outskirts, we're a mile and a half away from Motown Museum.
Yeah.
Fisher Building's right down the street. So we're pretty much in a very, like, the moment you make a left and go down, you can see off Grand.
You know what's crazy is the location of like this area.
Yeah,
because it's like nuts, because it's like we're so close to everything, but like when you, especially like on Hogarth, and if you go up like Dexter, like because I did a video on Dexter Linwood.
Yes.
And Dexter Linwood is like one of those places where it's just like amazing.
Yeah.
And then it's like really, really great, but it's just like, dude, it's just like it's ripe for renovation. Like even driving down Dexter, you're like, man, you could put like shopping plazas here and like
that's our makeshift bathroom right now.
Oh, right on. Now what have you done since you did the roof so far? Some of the electrical.
Yeah, this plumbing had to be redone. So all the electrical is redone completely, all the knob and tube is gone. And we have three different boxes for three different floors.
Yeah,
electrical, so it's and all separated.
I like the fact that you guys actually removed the knob and tube, and but you guys didn't demo everything out. Like he had a creative way to kind of work around it, which I thought was really cool.
Yeah, I'm really thankful for the electrician at the time, and yeah, it's really just he really set me up for trying to get this in exhibition order.
Yeah,
as opposed to like breaking down every wall. And
yes, exactly.
Like he did,
like have open walls everywhere.
You can see, he did strategic
work
with electricity where he set things up so that, you know, when we did have the time to demo it out or things that we obviously needed to demo, like we started demoing and then we stopped, but because we wanted to try to get the plumbing in right.
Yeah.
And now the plumbing is another thing that we have to focus
on. Yeah.
But at least we have really, working electricity, which is the main source of getting the whole house lit up and secure. This is a back addition that is kind of like going down. We're gonna try to see when it comes time to invest in it. That'll be like a later investment.
But jack it up.
Yeah, but there's a lot of these, like these pipes aren't necessary anymore. We gotta take those out. This is the second kitchen in this area, so kind of cleaned it out, made it ready for like a garbage disposal area. These are some of my, so right now I have all these shadow boxes that I created as art with my musical project that I've been focusing on creating, which took about 8 years to put together, and then a decade of patience is what I call it. And so you can walk through the whole exhibition now that essentially there was, with the house next door, there was a tree at the corner that was leaning into that house, and then it started leaning into this house, and so the roof started really getting messed up, and that's what caused all this water damage. So I mean, it was three shingles worth of
that's how many shingles you have on the roof.
Yeah, initially.
Oh my god.
Take it down, and then we had to put 75 boards of
plywood.
I didn't even go OSB because it was about the same price.
What was your cost of the tariff? 13?
No, that was before COVID. It was 25 grand.
Wow. Yeah. Oh my god.
That's what we do.
And this is how we ran the wires too, right here?
Yeah, isn't that?
That's so genius.
So yeah, I'd really love to thank Deshaun for that. He really took the, like, again, strategic electrical placement, made us wire the whole house, and you know, that's a, you know, you can always get new molding,
So, yeah, exactly.
But that, I think that pretty much was like a priceless investment. And then, but the thing that, so we have an artist in residency right now that's kind of like a catalyst for everything.
Yeah.
So this is her day space. Her addiction is actually the internet. And so she comes in here and has actual CDs and works off of those.
Oh, going online.
Yeah, she'll turn off her phone and and really just, she's been here on and off for a little bit over, I think right when the pandemic hit.
Okay.
And so, yeah, now we're trying to figure out ways of how we can accommodate her and then offer a membership.
Yeah. Right. No, that's a good idea. And these double doors, my favorite feature of the house. These doors, I love them, man. French doors are awesome.
Why not keep those?
No, absolutely. Beautiful. I love the fact, too, that you kept, like, all of, like, the hardware and the doors. Yeah.
I mean, obviously, we can do some, like, replacements here. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, I have no idea what they were thinking with, like, the locks on the inside. So essentially, this is a third triplex.
Yeah.
And we actually found, while we were cleaning it out, we found a new address.
Oh.
So there's a whole other address up here. And yeah, this is this space we're looking to like gut it so that it really opens up the roof and then have this be like a venue for artists to come and share their music or share their art or create like just a mini exhibition space.
Amazing.
And potentially it could also be the Airbnb for artists that are out of state that come and live in the future. So, but yeah, right now it's just kind of like, you can see it's another apartment on its own, but we have the makeshift like this.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I checked to see if this works, but they did run gas lines.
Yeah.
So, and it's still connected to a gas line. And this is essentially this is a third bathroom.
Oh, yeah, look at this.
I haven't really shown it because it's so out of...
Oh, yeah, this is run of the mill. I see this.
This is definitely run of the mill.
Yeah, I see this.
But, yeah.
Interesting.
So, essentially, they call that a servant's tub.
Yeah.
But
yep.
It's a whole nother... bathroom up here, so essentially three floors, three bathrooms, three kitchens. And yeah, this would be
And the end of the tour, I took the tour, if anybody's here. Genius.
Thank you, man.
Put on some headphones and that's do a walkthrough or everything.
Yeah,
it's awesome.
So I'd love for people to come through, but yeah, that's the intention of like really just honing in on one spot.
Mm-hmm.
Me being an artist that's really trying to understand what it really takes to rebuild a property in Detroit. I'm already thankful to have so much in here that was available to me.
Yeah.
But knowing that we still have a lot of work to do to just really revive a house.
Yeah.
And I commend people that really take the time, even ones that come from out of state, to try to renew Detroit, so to speak.
Yeah.
Because
it's annoying.
Absolutely.
I tell people when I make offers on houses, people are like, well, I was going to do this and that. I go, look, this is my profession and I even hate it. Like, it's so annoying, dude.
It's very challenging.
Extremely.
But you can see why a lot of people don't want to do it because of how challenging it is in the mind to really take on tasks. Everybody that looks at it is almost like, you know, people these days have the mentality of, what's just give me the key so I can
turnkey,
like,
yep.
Unlock the bathroom and go to the bathroom.
Right.
Just, you know, give me a place where I can just rest my head and not have to worry about looking at like something completely out of the ordinary.
Right.
And I say maybe it's time to rethink that. And yeah, it's sweat equity, but it's also knowledge that you get from all of this. So I'm very thankful for how much I've even learned even about electricity over the last year. To be able to do stuff to button up my own things as opposed to not really knowing it at all before.
Right.
Like, I didn't know about 12-2 wire.
Right.
All these numbers. But
they all mean something. Yeah. I still don't know.
Absolutely. So, yeah, and with each new trade worker that comes in here that offers knowledge, I really take into, like, I'm in class, basically.
Yeah.
And know that Like, that is an art in itself, and mm-hmm. people don't realize that, you know, architectural awareness and all this stuff to rebuild things like a house to live in is so necessary in this lifetime.
Yeah.
So,
yep.
So yeah, that's it, man.
All right, man. Well, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Let me turn this thing off.
Classic land bank house. Crappy steps, crap everywhere, structurally unsound. Yeah. Wow. That's fire damage for you. Look at this house next door. Oh, don't die. See ya, Alexander. Yo, look at this dumping. My man. Look at all these tires. Again, you guys, we're on Hogarth. I wonder if I can walk in this house. About to do some walking. Hey, yo. Hello? Is that a light? Oh, that was a light bulb.
Randomly walking in an abandoned house in Detroit. This is my life. Well, everybody, I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank Alexander for, you know, showing us the house, giving us a little tour of his passion project. And, you know, I want to make sure that this video kind of reaches the masses to show people out there that Detroit, this is what you see out in Detroit. This is when people think about Detroit. Think of vacant houses and just garbage everywhere. But what they don't see is the fact that people like Alexander are investing their time, their money, their efforts into putting art, investing back into the city, into real estate. And neighbor here as well, doing the same thing. Neighbors on this side. Yeah, compressor. Oh, hey, how you doing, man? You watch my channel? For real? Oh, snap. Sweet. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. I'm about to go across and meet a fan.